गुड मॉर्निंग वन एंड ऑल.
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेलकम टू TYBSC क्लास. सो माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर ज्योति गांगुर्डे, आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द सब्जेक्ट दैट इज जनरल पैथोलॉजी. दिस इज पेपर 6 ZY 336. नाउ द फर्स्ट लेक्चर इज ऑन द इंट्रोडक्शन रिगार्डिंग द सिलेबस एंड इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ जनरल पैथोलॉजी. So first we come to the syllabus, discussion regarding the syllabus. So here your first chapter, that is the introduction. In that the sub chapters such as definition, scope and basic branches of pathology. Then the next point, that is applied pathology. In that biopsy and surgery. And in next again here the autopsy and postmortem changes. These topics are covered under the first chapter, that is introduction. Now the second chapter, that is clinical pathology. So in that the sub chapters such as definition and scope of clinical pathology, then gastric analysis, urine examination, importance of CSF examination, CSF, that is cerebrospinal fluid examination, then liver function test and renal function test. This is your second chapter, that is clinical pathology. Then the third chapter, that is diseases. In that the topics such as definition and causes, and the next, that is infectious disease, its etiology and infectious agent. This is the third chapter. Now the fourth chapter, that is retrogressive changes. Now in that the definition of such a retrogressive changes, then cloudy, that is what the changes, then swelling, degeneration, fatty degeneration, mucoid degeneration and amyloid degeneration. This is the fourth chapter. Now the fifth chapter is the necrosis. In that the sub chapter sub points such as definition and causes of necrosis, then nuclear and cytoplasmic changes and types of necrosis. After that the sixth chapter, that is gangrene. In that the sub chapters such as definition and causes, then types of gangrene such as dry, moist and gas gangrene. The seventh chapter, that is circulatory disturbances. So in that the sub points such as hyperemia, in that active and passive, then ischemia, its causes and effects, then hemorrhage, its causes, effects and hemorrhagic effects. This is under the seventh chapter. Again some points such as thrombosis, that is thrombus formation, its causes and effects. And the last, that is embolism. In that the definition of embolism, sources, types and effects. This is under the chapter number 7. Now the next chapter, that is 8th chapter, inflammation. In that the points such as definition and causes, cardinals of inflammation, then vascular phenomenon and cellular responses. After that acute and chronic inflammation. So this is the chapter 8. Now the chapter 9 is repair. So the process of repair, then types, that is by regeneration, by connective tissue proliferation, and the last point, that is healing, in that primary and secondary methods. Now this is the chapter number 9. After that the next chapter, that is chapter number 10, neoplasia. In that the sub points, sub chapters such as definition of neoplasia, causes and types of tumors, that is benign tumor or malignant tumor. And again the next point, that is leukemia. In that the acute leukemia and chronic leukemia, these are the subtypes of leukemia. Now this is chapter number 10. After that the chapter number 11, in that disorders of pigmentation. Here the brief idea about normal processes of pigmentation, melanosis and jaundice. And the last chapter, that is disorders of mineral metabolism. In that, the mechanism of calcification, pathological calcification, causes and its effects. So this is what about the syllabus, a brief discussion regarding the syllabus. Now we come to, before that you see these are some reference books you have to follow during this course. I am giving you the notes from this book, that is textbook of pathology, 7th edition, and the author is Harsh Mohan, and here the publisher, that is Jai P. Brothers. Now here come to the first chapter, that is introduction of pathology, its definition, its scope or basic branches. So let us discuss regarding the definition of pathology. Here the word pathology, which is derived from two Greek words, pathos, that is meaning, that is disease, and logos, meaning the study. So that is the study of disease, that is pathology. So the pathology is the scientific study of disease, its nature, its causes and mechanism and effects. So the knowledge and understanding of pathology is essential for all would be the doctors as well as general practitioners and specialists, since unless they know the causes and mechanism of disease and understand the language spoken by the pathologist in the form of laboratory reports, so they would not be able to institute appropriate treatment or suggest the preventive measure to the patient. Only they give report to the doctors. Now you know the scope. The scope of pathology, that is one can be a good pathologist, one can be a laboratory assistant, one can be again do a work in blood banking as a technician or in hematology labs or in different research labs also. Come to the branches of pathology. So here some common branches of pathologies are there, such as histopathology, hematology, chemical pathology, immunology, experimental pathology, geographic pathology, medical genetics, as well as molecular pathology. So we can discuss all these branches one by one. Here the histopathology, which is used synonymously with anatomic pathology, then pathologic anatomy or morbid anatomy. Here morbid anatomy is the study of dead specimen, or particularly what we say is that the museum specimens. This is nothing but the morbid anatomy. That is the study of anatomy of museum specimen or the pathology of the morbid anatomy. So it is the classic method of study, and still it is the most useful one. Here the study includes structural changes observed by naked eye examination, or it is referred as gross or macroscopic changes. Such a changes we can observe by naked eyes, and such a changes particularly called as a macroscopic changes. And the changes, such a changes they detected by the light and electron microscopy supported by numerous spatial staining methods including the histochemical and immunological techniques to arrive at the most accurate diagnosis. So this is what we say that microscopic changes. So here the modern time anatomic pathology, which include the super specialities such as cardiac pathology, pulmonary pathology, neuropathology, renal pathology, gynecologic pathology, dermatopathology, gastrointestinal pathology, oral pathology, and so on. So here the anatomic pathology includes three main subdivisions such as surgical pathology, forensic pathology, or cytopathology. So here the surgical pathology, which deals with the study of tissues removed from the living body, it forms the bulk of tissue material for the pathologist and include the study of tissue by paraffin embedding technique and frozen section for rapid diagnosis. This is what particularly we say that suppose we are taking the tissue from suppose a person which suffer from any disease like cancer and all this. So we have to take the tissue. We have to take the tissue and we can analyze such a tissue by different tissue processing technique. So this is under the histopathology. Now after that, the next, that is forensic pathology and autopsy work, which include the study of organs and tissues removed at the postmortem. This after the death of person, that is the tissue which is removed from the person who going to die. So in this, the pathologist attempts to reconstruct the course of events, how they happen in the patient and culminated in his death. Here the postmortem anatomic diagnosis is helpful to clinician to enhance his knowledge about the disease and his judgment. Now this is what the forensic pathology. Now the cytopathology is a branch of anatomic pathology, has developed as a distinct subspecialty in recent time. It includes the study of cells shed off from the lesions. So it has a particular word, that is exfoliated cytology. So such a cells, they shed off from the lesion, that is exfoliated cytology. And the another one, that is the fine needle aspiration cytology, that is particularly we say that FNAC, or we say that a superficial and deep seated lesions for diagnosis. So by this, this is the needle FNAC, it is a needle, and by inserting such a needle to particular deep region of the body, we can collect the fluid, that is FNAC or aspiration cytology. Now this is what regarding the histopathology. After that, the next branch of the pathology is the hematology. So hematology, which deals with the disease of blood. So it includes the laboratory hematology and clinical hematology. Now the next branch, that is chemical pathology. So here the analysis of biochemical constituents of blood, urine, semen, CSF, that is cerebrospinal fluid, which is included in this branch of pathology. Now the next branch, that is immunology. So the detection of abnormalities in the immune system of the body, which consists of immunology and immunopathology. So this is what the immunology. Now the next branch, that is experimental pathology. So this is defined as the production of disease in the experimental animal and its study. So however, all the findings of experimental work in an animal may not be applicable to man. So due to the species differences. So suppose we are taking example, that is firstly what in India we are experiment on rats, on other mammals other than man. So we can do experiment on animals, but such a experiment they cannot applicable to man, because though they are mammal, but there are differences in the species. So then the next branch, that is geographic pathology. So the study of differences in distribution of frequency and type of disease in populations in different parts of the world, which forms the geographic pathology. So what it is actually, here the disease population from different parts of the world, this form collectively a geographic pathology. Now the next branch, that is medical genetics. So the medical genetics, this is the branch of human genetics that is deals with the relationship between heredity and disease. You know the heredity, that is the genes they can transfer from one generation to another generation. So and the disease which can transfer from one generation to another, that is what we say that the hereditary disease. So particularly here in medical genetics, so this is the branch of human genetics that deals with the relationship between heredity and disease. So there have been important developments in the field of medical genetics, such as in blood groups, then in inborn errors of metabolism, then chromosomal aberrations, in congenital malformations and neoplasm. These are some examples of such a medical genetics. Now the last branch of the pathology is the molecular pathology. So here molecular pathology, in this the detection and diagnosis of abnormalities at the level of DNA of the cell and is included in molecular pathology. So here abnormalities of DNA, such a abnormalities included in the branch of pathology, that is in molecular pathology. So students, this is what the discussion regarding here, the introduction of pathology, its definition, scope and basic branches. Now for that you have to refer the book which I mentioned in references. Such a books they are also available online, or such a books they are available in PDF forms also, and I also giving you notes. So this is what regarding the introduction. So thank you so much.